guys. Like I said, sorry for the late announcement about what we're going to be doing here. Kind of lost track of time this evening, so would have preferred to have given you guys more of a heads up, but it is what it is. Anyway, let's not waste too much time here. So when we last left off, we were... I think we finished the second level of the forges. So we're going to finish up the forges and hopefully one of the other chapters as well. Hit the switch, see what happens. Aesthetic of this particular world. It's like, you know, a bunch of crystalline looking enemies.
About it now.
Oh, it's up there. There we go. Shit was kind of annoying, so... Wait, there's health over here, too. Nice. So I can get 8 life right there. Yeah, whatever. Let's move on. There will be other health pickups as we move along, so no real reason to get bogged down with that. Is going to happen, happens, but whatever. We don't have any other play. Yeah. Fuck. I thought as much. Alright, well, at least it saved us here and not, like, way the fuck at the beginning like it did in that one level. That was bullshit. Thank you. So, what's the deal here? If I hit it and try and land like right there, so I kind of ride the thing up, I suppose that might work. No, because it goes. Wait, what's happening? So pretty much, if you go down there, it is death. In no uncertain terms. Son of a bitch. I'm not liking this. Or is that just the light from that one that I'm seeing? Yeah, maybe. Doesn't seem to be a way for me to, like, get through that over there. I can't shoot that, right? I do have to touch it. A real head scratcher here. We know what to do now. Let's see if I can claw these motherfuckers. See it there now. I didn't see that before. I there, so I gotta watch for that. Alright. We made it, that's all that matters. I don't want to do that shit again. See that at first. More more of this crazy platforming. Bitch. Alright, well, at least this one we can get the hell out of, you know. We're just totally boned. Crazy shit, dude. Go for the gusto sometimes. Shit. I feel like that's not gonna feel great. Exiting water mechanics in this are sort of weird. Don't work, like, perfect. There. noticed last time I was getting like kind of low on blue mana, so we're gonna come back and grab that real fast before we proceed.
Thank you.
shit. Save scum a little bit here, because that's like pretty fucking whack. I don't have to go through all that shit again. Oh my god. Wow. Yeah, I got fucked. Let's get out of here. Forsaken Sanctuary. Oh, this is the boss battle, isn't it? We have almost full BFG ammo. So I'm just all the Eterno from now on. I do want Alright, now we can go ahead and switch. Boss fight's pretty cool, though, I would say. But in my opinion, in a boss chamber, there should not be any spot for you to just, like, randomly fall. This is the boss fight for this particular episode that we're in right now. Yeah, in a manner of speaking. This is more closely related to Hexen or Heretic, if you're familiar with either of those games. A bit more of a, like, fantastical setting. Not so much, you know, space and technology and stuff. Not quite as much, anyway. But, it's got its own...
Welcome back, champion!
It's got its own mechanics, which are pretty sweet. Like you saw me use right there at the end. There's like a soul power mechanic, which basically gives your weapons a... like a stronger attack or whatever. Yeah, well, I mean, it was set on Mars, and, it certainly wasn't all space-themed or whatever, but it was set on Mars and Hell and, you know, whatever else. But this one is like, you know, there's no guns, per se, it's all, like, magic. Yeah. The whole premise of Mars is that, or of Doom, rather, is that there was a research station on Mars that opened up a portal to Hell. Okay, so, we've only got 2 episodes left to go. The Solar Solstice and the Sacred Path. I think Solar Solstice sounds cooler to me. But maybe I can't get in there until I do the Sacred Path as well. No, it was on Mars. Doom 2, conveniently named Hell on Earth, was set on Earth, but the original Doom was set on Mars. Anyway, so yeah, in this game, you've got all these worlds that you can go to, and you can basically approach them in any order that you would like to, and I don't know, it's really cool, lots of really odd platforming, kind of hard to explain. Yeah. But it's cool. I've been enjoying this a lot. Journeyman's Way leads to the Apostle's Shrine. Okay. So like this, for example, it's just kind of weird. I guess it's... probably die if I go down there, so I'm not gonna try. You get these, like, little floaty things like that. Those are the soul, like, fragments. And there's that bar below my health that is the soul meter. Basically, once that's full, I can activate the soul power that I was talking about. That allows me to have a more powerful attack. And each of the weapons has, like, a different property in terms of, like, what the empowered attack does. Like, so, for example, this one ends up giving you, like, heat-seeking shots. But these things, like, so the thing I just picked up and this guy over here are, like, basically the different ammo types. They use mana as, like, the ammo in this game. And all these are, like, health upgrades. Or, not upgrades, but health refills. And you can see down in the bottom right where it says mana, we've got the 4 different mana types. I don't have any purple mana at the moment, or until just now. But there are 4 types of ammo, and there are 2 weapons that use blue and green mana, one that uses orange, and one that uses purple. Yeah. So rather than like the traditional ammo and health system, it's a mana and health. this thing is that I've got right now is sort of equivalent to like a shotgun, I guess, would be probably the closest analogy in terms of a weapon you would be able to relate to. Go over here and read what this thing says. Okay, that's what I read earlier. Let's go up here. Like, one thing about this game is that it just has a really intricate and crazy level design. Like, every area has its own unique, like, enemies, everything. Pretty sweet. Yeah, to a degree. You could put it that way, I suppose. That will reveal the path that you need to go on to get out of there. Let's see, there was health over here. Okay. Alright, so we've got the gold key now. So we should be able to get out of here. Go in that one door that's over here on the right, I think, where this flame is. Too. makes the vine creatures stronger. Okay, keep that in mind. Likely than the other guys who look like stone. These guys are not particularly great. So, when you first start the game, this is like the first weapon they give you outside of the axe here. But what's cool is that nothing ever seems to go like totally obsolete. Like, you could use any of the weapons in certain circumstances, because this thing, like, heat seeks. So, in one of the other episodes that I played prior to this one, there was, an enemy type that was really good at dodging your attacks. So it's nice to have a heat-seeking one that, get blocked off there. Tracked them so you didn't have to worry about leading them as much or whatever. Okay. It's just big blue ammo. I had the gold key. Yeah, because I had to get the gold key to go in there, right? This thing is basically the BFG in this game, the Aeternum. I usually kind of reserve it. You don't get a ton of ammo for it, so I like reserve it for the boss fights. Giant protects the way. So let me turn him ammo. Whoa, sky. That's not something that you see a lot of in this game. Switch. I'm gonna go grab all that blue mana that was over there in this little area. I have no idea what's gonna happen. I wouldn't want to, like, lose the ability to do anything with that. So I think this is technically... So when you first start this, there's like two episodes that you have to play, like, by default, kind of the intro one and the one subsequent to that. But I think this is the first one that you're intended to play, so this is going to be slightly easier than some of the other ones that I've done prior. I did play this a little out of order, but like I said, you can approach it in whatever way you want. Thank you. is to look. Does chew through blue mana pretty quick, I will say. Basically, I gotta find... Oh, shit. surface. Okay. There we go. Easy peasy. Soul is like water. Then it chews through it. It's okay, I kind of felt like I had to do that or I was gonna die. This is where we came from, right? Yeah. And figure out how to get up there, that would be ideal. Doesn't appear that we're gonna be able to do it quite yet. Let's just go down here. Crushed. Okay. That's a pitch. Jump. Thank you. Alright, so we do have to go in that cistern or whatever. It's on the other place to go. Thank you. get that, I think. I'd like to have as much Eternum ammo as possible. Eh. Guess they were, but I guess I would have been wrong. I think actually down here. I guess we do need green mana pretty bad. Thank you. See, look at that. Right back up to being able to use the soul power again. Don't Bogart them. Use them. I knew how to get that, like, super health that was down there. I'll have to settle for one large health. Well, there's some health there, too. Switch down there.
Thank you.
no awards. We sucked it up on that level, apparently. Pilgrim's Temple. This thing's fucking hurt. Silver key. That's good to get. Thank you. Kind of an unexciting secret, but a secret nonetheless. I'll take it. Doesn't look like there's anything else over here. It's the waterfall. Shit. Whoops. Make sure you're walking on a platform. That'll get you where you need to go. Seem to like stun enemies, so even if it's not the most powerful individual shot, you are buying yourself some time to get some damage on them. Earth. Damn. Yeah, there's like a 1 in 45 chance or something like that for the planet on the celestial claw to be Earth. Speaking of which. But the moon. Does jack those guys up pretty good. missed something out here. These are totally enemies. I don't know why these have popped down. Alright, there's gotta be something down here. Yeah, okay. Oh, you're good, man. I enjoy having a lively chat, but that doesn't mean anyone ever has to feel obligated to chat. So that's why these guys haven't woken up yet. Yeah, there we go. See, there's her. I'm gonna go get all that shit. There's some orange mana in here anyway. Not a lot. Close enough to full as it is. Backtracking for all that stuff is not the best use of my time. Thank you. Celestial Claw ammo here. I do think on some level it's funny, like, how quote-unquote edgy they try to, like, have everything in this game. Like, the story, obviously, they take it like, way serious, whatever. But it's, like, not that serious. Let's see. Is there anything else I can do before I start risking jumping around? Save right here, why not? Okay then. His reality. Son of a bitch. Alright, well, at least I didn't fall. I almost thought I was gonna fall. lot of those little bastards in there. Alright, this should be last one in here, right? The boss fight. Oh, I don't doubt it. But by what? I think I have to grab this now, so I don't want to take damage for it later. We can use the Eternum ammo. There's a full health down there, I didn't realize that was even there. That'll be good to know. Alright. Fucked him up that time. The Eternal. is honestly the hardest boss that I've fought in this game so far. I don't know why there's like health out here. After we've already fought the boss. We got over a minute under the part time. Nice.
Welcome back, champion.
Alright, so all we have is Solar Solstice. That's the last one. How do I get over there? To go above. That'll be a tale for another time. Just a few minutes shy of 2 hours here, so I'm gonna get on out for the moment. I guess we can walk in there and see what's going on. I'm gonna wrap this one up for the time being. Be back here 8 o'clock, or rather 10 o'clock, and we'll do 10 to midnight. I can't talk. We'll do 10 to midnight of something or other. Probably not more medieval, because I do want to, you know, mix it up, keep it fresh. But I will let you guys know ahead of time, unlike what I did with this stream. sorry again for that. So if you want to join me then, that would be excellent. If not, I'll be uploading this as I always do, or almost always do, to my YouTube channel, so if you want to go there and watch it second time, if you didn't catch the first part, or if you just want to check out some of my other content, that's youtube.com/canman87. You can also follow me on Twitter, at canman87gaming. It's where I announce where, what I'll be playing, when I'm going live, things of that nature. And it's the best way to know any of that information, aside from following me on here. And if you enjoyed what you saw and you would like to follow me here, I would appreciate the support. Otherwise, if I don't see you later, guys, then that's totally fine. Just have a good rest of your weekend, and we'll just catch you next time.